Local residents and commuters just 40 miles from New York City had been reporting sightings of an unusual object in the night skies for over a year and a half. Sightings were reported on at least 50 separate nights during the 18-month period. Over 9,000 eyewitnesses, lawyers, teachers, CPAs, advertising executives, nurses, and factory workers reported seeing the unidentified phenomena. Newspapers and television almost weekly carried reports of the sightings. From different places throughout the area, eyewitnesses all reported seeing the same thing.
I looked up and right over my head, virtually. And it wasn't far off, it was right over my head and very still. There was a rim of lights in the shape of a triangle.
It was just a tremendous object. It was anywhere from wingtip to wingtip, about 50 or 60 yards.
These were very, very unusual lights. I've never seen anything like it in my life. And so I pulled my car over and I had to take a look.
I mean, he would drive down the road and look up in the sky.
Some people, like Bob and Lori Pozzioli, were determined to film the object.
And then one night, he spotted this one round object. And that's when he called me and he said, quick, let's get the camera. And we did.
Oh, good God.
What do you think?
I don't know.
Not quite.
I'm going to tell you something, honey. I don't know what the hell it is.
It's rotating.
Bob and Lori photographed this unidentified flying object near their home in Brewster, New York. Bob is a vice president in a Manhattan computer firm. Some of their friends and Lori's parents thought they were crazy, despite this photographic evidence.
It's turning very, very slowly.
9,000 odd people have seen this thing, or whatever it is, and they all just can't be crazy.
Could it have been an aircraft or many smaller light planes flying in formation? The media attention given the sightings prompted six pilots at a local airport to try to prove that it could be just that. Amused by the idea of UFOs, the pilots planned and flew at least 18 daring nighttime missions, flying in formation, sometimes without lights. This hoax fooled at least some of the eyewitnesses, but not Bob and Lori. They claimed that in addition to photographing the UFO, they also videotaped the light airplanes as they enacted their hoax.
There are six, and the lead one has his three lights on. Everybody else only has two. Did you hear the engines?
Some UFO investigators agree that many of the reported sightings were probably of the hoax. But some eyewitnesses, they say, were clearly able to differentiate between the hoax and the unidentified object.
As it was coming over, there was a star in the sky, and as the lead light went under that star, right behind it, you could still see the star, which meant it was not a solid object. And as it was going overhead, you did hear engines. All right, now, what kind of aircraft engines, I don't know, but you did hear aircraft engine noise.
Engine noise, different lights, and different flying movements, UFO proponents say, clearly make the airplanes IFOs, identified flying objects. But this object, or objects, remains unidentified for many. This New York State event occurred over a densely populated area and over a nuclear plant.